You're gonna play a song, Big Red. If you guys want to hear it again, call me 510-723-6981. Hit me up on the KCRH radio request line. Ellen Perez is still here
with the homies
movie. Now, I told the people that I was gonna jump into some more serious questions after the break, but somebody on your Instagram asked you what part of Fairfield, what they said, where did you grow up in Fairfield? And you were like, Fairfield.
No, I'm just playing.
But what part of Fairfield?
I grew up, because honestly, I lived all over Fairfield. Like, I lived in, you know, for those that don't know, there is like an east and a west and all that. So I grew up like in the east, I guess you could say that. And then I moved to Sassoon. And I went to Army and stuff, so I stayed in, you know, in Sassoon most of the time. So.
Okay.
It's all one though, you know what I mean? Once you cross the railroad tracks, you're pretty much in like different cities. So it's like Fairfield, Sassoon is right there. But yeah, I went to Cliff Gordon Elementary. I went to Army Ohio, Sullivan Middle School. Now Sullivan Middle School is not even there no more. So shout out to everybody from Fairfield, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoever that is, you better be from Fairfield. Questioning my turf.
Yeah, asking you, Tay, family. Where you from, bruh?
Questioning where I'm from.
All right, now, to get a little bit serious, a couple of months ago, I don't know when this was. I don't think we've already talked about this.
I don't know.
But there was some point where I think you were talking about not doing music. This is your last project or your last album, or you're stopping, and you're not going to do music anymore.
He dug deep.
I had to.
Journalism at its best.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, man, I definitely hit that point in my life.
Now, why? Because the last time I had you in here, you were on a different. You all right, bro?
Yeah.
You were on a different.
I'm trying
path.
Not to sneeze.
It's
I'm
all good. You can just turn away from the mic. If you have to sneeze, you have to sneeze. But you were on a good path. Everything was working out cool. You had the EP, the All In EP, dropped. Everything was fine. You were talking about the Stay True album coming out.
Mm-hmm.
You were saying a lot of things that weren't going good were going cool at the time, and then all of a sudden, a little while afterwards, I didn't comment on it, and I didn't like try to dig into it. I sat there and I had a text message. It's probably still saved in my phone as a draft, but I didn't send it to you asking you what was going on.
Yeah,
I felt like I was trying to get too much in your business. But now, since we're on the radio, I'm gonna ask you like,
now I'm getting your business.
Yeah, now I'm getting your business, bro.
Listening.
Yeah. Now, like, now what happened, bro? Like, why did it go from all good to all bad like that?
I just think, like kind of like how I was saying earlier, how I cried yesterday because my album came up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't release a lot of energy sometimes. Like, I just hold stuff in. So, like, mm-hmm. when I'm feeling a certain way, like, if I'm not making records about it, it just stays right here because I don't talk to a lot of people. So,
mm-hmm.
I think at that time I was just, you know, being a human, man, just feeling certain ways about the industry. You know, this industry, it just takes a toll on you. You know what I mean? Because it takes you from being, a real person sometimes to a character, you know what I mean? And it's like, I don't want to be that, and I definitely don't like the pressure of feeling like I have to do that. So sometimes it's like, do I really want to do this?
Mm-hmm.
Like, is my happiness more important than trying to pursue some stuff that's already designed for you to fail sometimes? Like,
now, was it a spontaneous decision? Was it one thing that just put you over the top, or was it just a combination of a bunch of things taking place at that time that caused you to feel that way?
It was a combination, man. Just built up, you know, over the years. You know, I've been going at this music stuff since I was 17, you know what I mean? So it's like 10 years later, a lot of stuff hasn't changed. You know, I've grown as a person and as an artist, but, you know, it's the same game, just different players.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just, you know, at one point, I just got fed up. Like, you know, I'm tired of this politics, and I'm tired of dealing with people that don't really got my best interests at heart. They just waiting for me to provide some value to them. And mm-hmm. a lot of people, you know, they see that and they be like, well, what are you crying for? You chose to be in this career. All right, but I feel like certain things don't have to be that way.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And that's just me. So I was basically more so just venting to the public, you know what I mean? So they could see that I'm human and I definitely have, you know, these emotions that you're dealing with. But I had a lot of good friends call me and talk to me, and some of them chewed me out like, bro, you tripping. You better get up off your ass and, you know, make some music.
Because you left from here talking about the deal you had going on with Empire, talking about the project coming out.
Yeah.
I think there was a project that the All In EP had that's the thing that confused me. That's what threw me off. Like, I'm like, all right, well, he just got a deal.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
You got to understand
just started
something.
Working with like, him. Like,
I started doing music just for the love of it.
Uh-huh.
I didn't never sell my music till 2013.
Mm-hmm.
Never made money off my music. I just, you know, I have a gift of being able to put words together. So once I started feeling like it was a job, it wasn't fun no more.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So I had to remind myself, you know, why do I even want to do this? It ain't for money. It ain't for fame. I've been broke for 9 years, basically. You know what I'm saying? So it was like I had to, you know, kind of go down that avenue just to kind of find out what was really motivating me to make music. You know, and at one point I did feel like I was, it was just a job. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I gotta record these songs. Oh, this dude just paid me for a verse. I gotta go knock it out. Like, it wasn't coming natural no more. So me going through that and talking to everybody and seeing like the fans reach out to me and was like, man, you, bro, your music get me through everything, bro. Like, you, if you stop, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm like, I didn't know it was like that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it made me refocus. And, you know, I mean, who's to say what would be my last album, my first album, or whatever. But I'm just trying to stay positive, man, and make good music for people that do want to hear my music.
Now, we should expect more music, right?
Yeah.
That's over with. That's not going to come up again. Or that's something that's just in the back.
If I do feel that way, I won't announce it.
But
right now, I don't feel that way. But okay. If it comes to that again, I won't announce it. Or make it known. I'll just work through it on my own or whatever. You know what I mean? But at that point, I was just fed up with a lot of things that was going on, man, and I just had to talk about it. And I'm glad I snapped out of it because I do have blessings in front of me. But it was just, you know, I'm a human. I got to go through things,
man. Yeah,
it
happens. Yeah. It happens to the best of us.
I mean, you know, like, you know, my grandmother passed away last year in March. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't even go through, like, a grieving period because there was so much other stuff going on with my music that I was just trying to work through it, like, oh, I got to record. I got to do something to take my mind off it. So, I mean, it could have just been a number of things. You know what I mean? So, shout out to everybody who did reach out to me because y'all some real ones.
For sure.
Yeah. You about to throw up?
No.
Are you all right, Ellen? Like,
I'm fine. I'm just not feeling good. I'm sorry.
Man, you just scared the hell out of me.
Yeah, go.
All I could think about is, like, where the projectile was going to come.
Yeah, like, where it was going.
Oh, okay. I made it weird.
Yeah, we were all in the moment and everything, listening to you and stuff.
You kind of made it weird, not me.
Yeah, your eyes got all watered. I'm like, is Ellen about to cry?
Yeah, I was like, damn, what did I say?
Yeah.
That's crazy. But nah, man, I'm glad you asked that because, you know, I just had a talk with somebody today and was like, bro, see, that's why you should never talk like that, bro, because you got good things going on. But, you know, I'm excited about everything, man. I think I just needed to rejuvenate and go through that. That reboot, you know what I mean? Like, we like computers, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes we got to shut down so we can get back to where we need to be.
For sure.
Yeah.
That's what's up. That's good that everything, you feel me, is, you know, everything is pretty much back on track, bro.
Yeah.
That everything's working in the right direction and stuff like that for you. Happy you dropped the project. Don't stop.
Yeah, man.
Not
I
now.
Can't, man. I mean, you know, even if I wanted to, I just watched the Jay-Z Fade to Black movie a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
That was supposed to be his last album. Black album. Was
yeah, for real.
You know what I mean? He was making it, you know, like it was his last album. And that's because he had felt like he had said and did everything that he wanted to say up until that point. Do I feel that way sometimes? I'm not Jay-Z, but I've said a lot of things already. But I still haven't lived in certain experiences, so I still got more to talk about. You know what I mean? So
for sure.
I can't wait. I can't wait.
There we go.
And there you have it.
Right. There you have it. Y'all just got some gems right there.
Yeah, that's how we do, man.
I've never addressed that conversation, so that's what's up.
Well, hey. Gotta address it somewhere.
Yeah.
We're gonna ask you good questions, bro. We're not gonna dwell on the same stuff. We're not gonna try to bring out anybody's relationship issues.
Well, you can't do that with
females
me
and stuff.
I'll curve you straight up.
Don't curve me, bro.
I'll curve those answers and questions.
All right. any shout outs, anything you want to say to the people?
Well, first and foremost, man, I want to shout out the fans, man, because this is really like y'all made this happen. Like, stay true, and everything that's going on for me right now would not have happened if the people didn't speak for me. So thank you to y'all, and shout out to my team, man, Brian Chernick, Amore Jr., Christina Love, you know, my girl back home, my kids, man, everybody, like, just thank y'all for, you know, supporting me and getting me through everything. My mom, my dad, you know, they helped me out a lot. They actually chose How You Love That as a single.
Well, there you go.
My parents did that. I'm just letting y'all know.
Well, damn.
So, yeah, man, I'm just excited, man. Shout out to the label, man. Shout out to everybody that's a part of the album. You know, I ain't going to individualize it because it's too many people. But,
yeah,
man, I'm happy, man. Thank you. Shout out to everybody. Blessings.
It's all good. KCIH 89.9 FM. Stay true. Available online right now.
Yeah, baby.
Ready? Bombs away. Perhaps you've heard this popular.